Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, whereby we are going to interact and learn together. We are going to have our biology from 3 lesson 20, whereby your tutor will be me, Mr. Gerald. We are going to handle the topic on ecology and the subtopic the sources of soil pollution. But before that, we are going to look at our lesson goal, whereby by the end of the lesson, you should be able to give causes of soil pollution. So let us begin and follow up the lesson. You are welcome. There are several sources of soil pollution which include oxides of sulfur, we have aerosol sprays, we have petroleum products, we have inorganic fertilizers. We also have petroleum products. Another source of soil pollution is inorganic fertilizers. We also have solid waste. We also have radioactive emissions. So I am going to explain these sources of soil pollution as I have just given the points. So let us begin as I'm explaining the points. The first point that I'm going to explain will be the oxides of sulfur. Then we can see that the oxides of sulfur include sulfur 4 oxide and they enter the soil through precipitation as acid rain. Acid rains alter the soil pH, therefore affecting the plants and animals, and that cannot tolerate acid soil. However, acid rains may promote the growth of plants that tolerate acids, acidic conditions. Acid rains also causes leaching of minerals, leading to loss of soil fertility. The second source of soil pollution we have seen is the aerosol sprays. Then we can say most aerosol sprays are sprayed to control pests and diseases in plants and animals, contain heavy metals, e.g. We have the copper and mercury. Chemicals fall on the soil and are taken up by plants where their concentration increases. As animals eat these plants, toxicity increases and leads to death of animals. These chemicals kill nitrogen-fixing soil microorganisms, hence lowering soil fertility with subsequent reduction of plant growth. Another source of soil pollution we have seen is the petroleum products. So for the petroleum product, we can say that when they spill on land, e.g. the tangas soils, soil organisms fail to obtain oxygen in oil-saturated soils, and therefore die. Coating of plant leaves or respiratory surfaces of animals also leads to their death. We can see as on our diagram, in our screens, our diagrams, another source is inorganic fertilizers, whereby agricultural inorganic fertilizers contain phosphates and nitrates. These increase soil acidity so that soil microorganisms cannot inhabit such soils. Formation of soils or soil organic matter slows down and then stops. Soils become exhausted, hence plant and animal life ceases. In addition, soil structure is changed, hence encouraging soil erosion. Another source of soil pollution we have, as we are seeing, is solid waste. For the solid waste, we can say that community household waste and industrial waste. Some are biodegradable, for example, the food that we consume, or the old clothing and papers. Others are non-biodegradable, for example, the rubber, plastics, containers, scrap metals, and glass bottles, as we can see from our diagrammatic representations there. Solid waste are a nuisance and may lead and may also be injurious. For example, the glass bottles. They destroy the aesthetic state of the environment. They offer breeding grounds for pests, rodents, and insect vectors, which in turn pose health hazards to human beings. The non-biodegradable solid waste limits soil aeration, thus inhibiting microorganisms' activity. We can now look at how we can be able to control soil pollution. As you know, all solid waste should be sorted out according to manufacturer's specifications. Then, appropriate disposal methods are applied. One, we can recycle solid waste, for example, the polythene papers and the plastic containers, glass bottles, paper, and also the scrap metals. Another way of controlling soil pollution is whereby The household waste that are biodegradable can be disposed in a compost pit to form compost manure for organic farming. The combustible solid waste, for example, the old clothes, sanitary towels, or air, should be burnt in incinerators. That is a way of controlling soil pollution. Another way is you discourage excessive use of agrochemicals. Another way of avoiding soil pollution is you use biological control of pests and diseases to be to encourage that. That is, you encourage the biological control of pests and diseases rather than chemicals. You also encourage pipeline transportation of petrol and petroleum products to minimize risk of spillage. The last and not the least about soil pollution is you enforce appropriate legislation on proper solid waste management. Having said and done that, we can have our today's activity whereby you are required to state and explain the causes of soil pollution. For, to get more information on this lesson, you can refer to KLB, Secondary Biology Students Book 3, which is the 4th edition, Nairobi, and it has been certified by the Kenya Literature Bureau. To get these biology lessons and many more, you can send us an SMS to the number that is on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or our Facebook page, which is also Elimu TV, or you tweet us at Elimu TV _Kenya. Let us subscribe for these lessons, and we shall enjoy. Thank you.